Feminist Creativus presents A Word for Every Generation That Knows No Fashion.
I hope and trust us to find you well, my friends. It has been a journey from Monday through to Friday, and we can only say, praise the Lord, we have made it this far. As we start this devotional, I also recommend that you check out the one we did on Monday on the Minority Report. You may find some background information. If you are able to do so, God bless your soul. But if you have no time, let us enjoy the one we have right before us. We are at Numbers chapter 14, and we begin reading at verse 10 in the Holman Bible. The Bible reads as follows. While the whole community threatened to stone them, the glory of the Lord appeared to all the Israelites at the tent meeting. The Lord said to Moses, how long will these people despise me? How long will they not trust in me, despite all the signs I have performed among them? I will strike them with a plague and destroy them. Then I will make you into a greater and mightier nation than they are. May the good Lord bless the reading of his word as we spend this moment in prayer. Let us pray, my friends. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of listening to your word. How we pray, dear Father, that we may cease to despise your word, cease to despise those you have appointed and anointed, and above all, may we trust you. This is our prayer of faith. Come and tabernacle with us and in our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray and we ask, amen. My dear friends, just allow me to raise 5 points as we take off. Notice as we begin, Moses and Aaron in the devotional we did on Monday, they fell on their knees and faces were bowed down and prayed to the Lord in front of the entire community of Israel. As they prayed, the Holy Spirit moved upon Joshua and Caleb to testify and offer the minority report. After giving the minority report, the children of Israel now respond by threatening to stone Moses and Aaron. As they threaten to stone them, I want you to take note. This is how God responds. He responds by appearing at the tent of the meeting. His presence is immediately shown to the entire community of Israel. What am I saying to you? Perchance you are in the position of Moses. Perchance you are in the position of Aaron. As you are interacting with the children of Israel, the children of Israel have a tendency, the children of Israel have a propensity to seek to take the lives of the prophets and of their leaders. Should they seek to take your life, be of good cheer, be of good courage. God shall manifest his presence. God shall protect you. God shall be ever at your side, for he has sent you on this errand. Do not shy away from lifting up the banner of our Lord and Savior and doing as thus saith the Lord. Point number two. The children of Israel, as they go on to do all these things, God now appears and he takes this particular format. I found it very interesting. First of all, he goes on a question format. Secondly, he then gives his verdict. And lastly, he will give his counter offer. What are the questions that God raises? These two questions, I believe, they constitute his investigative phrase. The investigative phase comprises of these. At point number two, expressing a law opinion of God. God says, how long will these people despise me? God is speaking about something that has been observed over time, something that has been collated over time, and he sees these people now have a disposition. These people have made it their practice over time to have a low opinion of me. They do not only despise me as king, they do not despise me as creator, they do not despise me as their leader, but all these combined, they continue to despise me. I brought them out of captivity. They are not grateful for that. I have fed them. They are not grateful for that. I have protected them. They are not grateful for that. I have fought battles for them and I have won on their behalf. They are not grateful for that. They despise me. An ungrateful Lord. God is asking this question over time. Before you come to the conclusion that someone despises you, someone has a low opinion of you, I hope you are not basing your conclusion on one incident. God says how long? It has been an extended period. His patience has been tested. His patience is running thin. The second question he puts across at point number three. He says, how long? How long will they not trust in me? In spite of all the signs I have performed among them. The miracles that God has performed, parting the Red Sea, that was a miracle. The miracle of God even feeding them with manna, that was a miracle. The miracle that they saw and witnessed every day. The miracle of the fire by night to keep them warm, that was a heating system, a miracle. The miracle of a shade by day to cool them, that was a miracle. The miracle of even the cloud that gave them the marching orders and the direction, that was a miracle. The quails as well, another miracle. But they still have no trust in me. Moses is receiving this question from God. It is more like a rhetoric question. And God maybe is putting this question across to us. And he says, how long will you continue to receive miracles and still not trust him? We are a nation that goes off to seek miracles up to a point that Jesus said, this generation shall not receive any other miracle except the miracle of Jonah. We are not going to receive any further miracles. Because of our insatiable appetite for miracles, we have gotten even those who are going to dabble with magic and do all these kinds of things so that we may think the Lord is in our presence when he has long left us. God says we have been given more than enough to trust him. Point number four, as we near the end, notice that the children of Israel, God is saying, how am I going to deal with them? The verdict now. I'm going to strike them with a plague. Not with plagues, just one plague, and destroy them. The Egyptians were given all in all 10 plagues. Of these 10, the first three of these plagues covered the whole of Egypt and the Israelite territory. But the last 7, they covered the Egyptian territory exclusively. Now, when God deals with his children, he says, you, because you understand what it means to walk with me, you understand what it means to hear my voice, I will not give you 7 plagues. I will strike you once and I'll be done with you. When we walk with God, we risk imminent extermination. We risk imminent expulsion. But those who are away and farther from God, they are given multiple plagues so that they may come to repentance. But those who have it all, much is expected of them. Lastly, God now says to Moses, this one we covered 2 or so devotionals ago, do not build graves, your success upon the graves of others. I'll recommend that you check out this devotional. But I want to stress one more angle here. Take note, when we, disregard the grace of God, when we treat it flippantly, do not behave as if God has a short supply of whom to bless. When we do not want to be grateful for what the Lord is doing, there is always a Moses next by that God can bless. Do not behave as if God is desperate to bless you. He is not desperate. There is always a Moses. He can start afresh until you meet again on Monday morning. Reflect upon this. God can always bless the next person. If you have the opportunity to be blessed, be blessable. May God bless and keep you until Monday morning. Amen.